Hello everyone, welcome to this KSP IVA tutorial, which will be part 1 of a tutorial series about flying retro-style IVA spacecrafts. In this first part, we'll take a look at the FDAI instrument, or Flight Director Attitude Indicator. This is basically the equivalent of the stock KSP navball. First, we'll start with some history and quick description. The FDAI, also nicknamed 8 ball, referring to the black colored number 8 ball in the game of pool, is one of the most important instruments in the spacecraft. Designers had originally intended to give the crew 3 separate displays to show their attitude, one each for roll, pitch and yaw. But being pilots, the crews quickly threw out the 3 displays in favor of a development of the artificial horizon familiar from aircraft instrument panels. In an aircraft, of course, the Earth horizon provides an obvious reference against which the artificial horizon displays attitude. However, in a spacecraft, such an obvious reference may not exist or be visible. So the inertial platform at the center of the inertial measurement unit thus provides one, meaning a reference that is constant relative to the stars, known as inertial reference. The FDAI can be configured to use known positions relative to Earth, the Moon or the stars, so that the engineers, scientists and astronauts can communicate the relative position, attitude and orbit of the spacecraft. But as we know in KSP, it will simply switch to the celestial body reference which you are currently orbiting. And you can clearly see that, for instance, when you pass from Earth SOI to the Moon one. The basic function of the FDAI is to display the spacecraft's attitude with respect to the orientation of the inertial platform. Pitch and yaw can be read off the ball directly. Roll is shown by a pointer around the edge of the 8 ball. 3 meters around the display show the rate of rotation around the 3 axes. And then we have 3 additional orange needles in front of the ball, which graphically display the difference between the current and desired attitude of the spacecraft. The FDAI was first found on the Gemini spacecraft and of course its successor, Apollo. Now having seen the history and description bits, we can get back to the game and dive in. I'm here sitting in the Apollo command module in a typical low Earth orbit. So the main difference between the 8 ball and the stock KSP nav ball is that we don't have our usual velocity vector displayed, as you can see. So the question, how do I point to my prograde vector, for instance? Well, let me introduce you to the 8 ball KSP's companion, the FDAI mode control panel. This panel selects which vector the arrow needles display. In addition to the 6 cardinal orbital vectors, prograde, retrograde, radial, etc., etc., the FDAI can be configured to show the surface velocity, as well as the maneuver node vector, target direction, and target relative velocity. It can also be used to place the FDAI in docking port alignment mode, which we will discuss later. The plus minus switch controls whether the FDAI points towards a vector or towards the anti-vector. For instance, when the mode dial is set to orbital, setting this switch to plus will indicate prograde, and conversely, the minus positions will show retrograde. So now let's give it a quick example. Say we want to point to the prograde vector. I'll then switch to orbital and plus. And now I need to change my attitude to align with the arrow needles. And there we go. Let's take this occasion to examine the scale selector switch's behavior. Those switches control the scale of the arrow needles and rate arrows. These rate selectors allow us to switch between course adjustment and fine-tuning. The FDAI arrow scale switch can set the maximum range of the arrow needles to 12, 60 or 120 degrees. Each tick mark next to the arrow needles counts of 2, 10 or 20 degrees based on the switch setting. On the other side, the FDAI rate scale switch sets the maximum reported rate of the rate arrows to 10, 50 or 100 degrees. Each tick mark next to the rate arrows correspondingly reports 1, 5 or 10 degrees per second. Let's illustrate this. This time I want to align to retrograde, which is my opposite vector. So I set the error scale to the maximum for course adjustment. This is useful to evaluate how far or close I'm from my desired direction, and also, for instance, to avoid doing excessive RCS orientation burns. Then I select 10 degrees per second of rate scale, which is enough here. I also disable SAS, since I want to control manually my attitude by just giving an initial impulse and then letting my spacecraft drift in the desired direction, which the stock SAS doesn't do very well. In fact, it's quite horrible at efficient attitude changes. So let's do it. I start with a pitch change. And here we can see it reports 4 meters per second, which is okay. And I let myself drift along, while still keeping an eye on the other axis stability. So we are now nearing the desired attitude, and from the needle scale I know we are less than 20 degrees from retrograde. So I slow down a bit, and also switch the error scale to the maximum precision of 12 degrees. And we should be good. So yeah, here obviously we all know that in low orbit with zero inclination, retrograde is gonna be at 270 heading always. So why bother with all this? Well, this is just an example, and this known heading will not be true in most other orbits configurations. So now let's take a look at a topic I discussed earlier. When the FDAI is configured to target and minus, which is also docking port, as you can see, it then goes into docking port alignment mode. However, this mode is only enabled when the craft is targeting a docking port, of course, and a docking port is being used as the reference part on the craft. If either of these conditions are false, the DPAI will go into error mode. But now we are good, and we can see the 8-ball indeed displays a DP flag. When in DPA mode, the FDAI provides yaw, pitch and roll information on the arrow needles, allowing us to align the craft with the targeted docking port. The only difference to the regular FDAI modes is that we have roll to care about when docking. So naturally, there's now a third needle active for roll display, which wasn't the case before. This instrument, combined with the altitude, range, round rate and X-pointer instruments, that will be discussed in later tutorials, allows for fast and very precise manual dockings. Lastly, sync to SAS tells the FDAI to automatically use the currently selected SAS mode as its target vector. So I had to change capsules since the Apollo 1 doesn't have SAS modes, but yeah, you can see it's just really a visual confirmation that the SAS is doing its job correctly, really. By the way, I highly encourage you trying to fly without SAS, or very minimal, since it gives really a sense of completely controlling the craft, which is great, and also allow for better attitude changes, as we saw. And yeah, if you're in stock KSP, I suggest you disable the reaction wheels and use RCS instead for attitude changes. Just to try, because it's well, it's harder and more fun and challenging. I see it like that. So this concludes this part 1 of this IVA tutorial series. And also, if you want to see those concepts applied in a real KSP mission, I just recently recreated the full Apollo 11 mission in occasion of the 54th anniversary, and this in real solar system and realism overhaul, and of course entirely flown from the cockpit. So yeah, thanks for watching everybody. Please feel free to ask questions if you have any, or give any type of feedback. Goodbye!